Hey folks, it's me AndyTheDead, and today we're starting to play a new old game, Pokémon the Trading Card Game, a game that came out for Game Boy back in 1998. Fuck, I'm old. I have a history with trading card games. I have been playing trading card games since 1999. Magic the Gathering was and will always be my gospel. I have played some weird ones, some not weird, rather less known ones, like the Lord of the Rings trading card game that was amazing, The Legend of the Five Rings, what was the other one? Warcraft trading card game, World of Warcraft trading card game, not Hearthstone, the original World of Warcraft trading card game that was actually my favorite, but this one, Pokémon trading card game, was the one I didn't have the chance to play as much as I wanted. So the outlet was the Game Boy version, and this is what we are playing today. Also, let me say that I've played a few rounds just to remember the rules a bit, and yeah, don't expect me to make the best deck or the best decisions about the game, because I'm not as familiar with it as I'd like to be. But words are wasting time, so let's get going. Alright, we're starting a new game. Let's name the character, yeah, Red, just as an homage to the original Pokémon. Red is crazy about Pokémon and Pokémon card collecting. One day, Red heard a rumor. The legendary Pokémon cards, the extremely rare and powerful cards, held by Pokémon trading card game's greatest players, the Grandmasters, are searching for one to inherit the legend. Dreaming of inheriting the legendary Pokémon cards, Red visits the Pokémon card researcher Dr. Mason. The world map. Oh, why the rush, Red? What? You want to learn how to play the Pokémon trading card game? I kinda know already, so... yeah. So you too finally want to start playing the card game. Well, dueling is more fun than just collecting cards. First, you should try playing with a practice deck. Here, I'll give you this deck, and now you need an opponent. Hey Sam, play with him for a while. Yes, Dr. Mason. Hello, Red. Okay, let's give it a try. Hey Red, I didn't come here. Yeah, I kinda expected that. First, ask Sam the basics of the game. Okay Red, what do you want to ask about? Yeah, the greatest way to learn playing the game is to actually play it, so nothing to ask. Is that all? Yes, it is. They say that actions speak louder than words, so let's play a game. My words exactly. Since this is your first time, just try to learn the basic steps. I'll be coaching you, so follow my advice. If you don't do as I say, we won't be able to proceed. It might be easier if you read the Pokémon Trading Card Game instruction booklet while we play. Okay then, let's start your practice game. Finally. Since this is just a practice, don't shuffle the deck. Each player will draw 7 cards. Yeah, that's pretty standard. Choose a basic Pokémon to place in the arena. We drew 7 cards and get ready for the battle. You can only choose basic Pokémon as active ones. Yeah, okay, I remember that. So choose Goldeen or Staryu. For our practice, choose Goldeen. There we go. And Goldeen, level 12, was placed in the arena. And we may choose up to 5 basic Pokémon to place on the bench. Alright, then this is our team, I guess. We can switch, yeah, between those. Only basic Pokémon placed on the bench, yeah. And now let's place Staryu on the bench. And when we are ready, we press B to finish. Fantastic. Oh, right, and this game plays with prizes. Yeah, if you are the first to collect the 6 or 4 or 3 prizes, depending on how the match goes, you win. Or if you don't, if your main Pokémon, your active Pokémon, faints and you have no benched Pokémon to play, then you lose. This time we're playing with 2 prizes. That's great. Toss the coin. and we play first. Draw a card. Water energy. Right, this doesn't play like magic. We have to attach the energy cards directly to the Pokémon so we can use their abilities. Yeah, more rules. Alright, the training match is pretty much on rails. So we use the energy card and attach it to Goldeen. And now we can attack with the basic horn attack for 10 damage. And now some plays. And he attacked us with low kick for 20 damage. Alright. Our Goldeen is going to get knocked out. Let's evolve it. With a Seeking. I don't remember all the Pokémon, to be honest. But it doesn't have enough energy to use its ability. Yeah, we need to attach some more. The star energy means any type of energy card. That's great. Alright. So, we evolve Goldeen to Seeking. And attach the psychic energy on it. And now we attack with the waterfall ability. For 30 damage. Alright, just 10 damage away. And he places a Rattata on the bed. Yeah, he's preparing that. 20 damage to Seeking. Alright. And the water energy. Yeah, Seeking has enough energy, so we're going to place it on Staryu. And when we defeat a defending Pokémon, we pick a prize. Attaching a water energy to Staryu. And we attack. Yeah, the horn attack will be enough. Doesn't matter really which one you choose. Let's get the first prize. It's just one water energy. And now Rattata is his active Pokémon. And it evolves it to Eradicate. Wow, that's almost... Oh, no, that's actually double the health. And we're just 10 damage from having our Pokémon knocked out. We drew a Drowsy, a psychic Pokémon, yeah. Yeah, that's how we lose a game. I mentioned this before. Alright, now we can play Drowsy and put it on the bench. Let's attach the water energy to it. And we end the turn by attacking. And now our Pokémon is going to get knocked out. And he picks a prize. And now we choose a bench Pokémon to replace Seeking. Yeah, Staryu seems a better choice. It is important to know your cards and the status of your Pokémon. I will learn most of the cards during the gameplay. And we drew a potion. Yeah, that heals 20 damage if I remember correctly. Right, we are going to get Staryu prepared for when it evolves to a Staryu. This is a non-realms match. The cards that we're going to draw are specific and in order. Now let's attack. And he's just one hit away from being knocked out. Places another matchup that doesn't matter. Oh, he withdrew Raticate. Alright. I'm guessing it's Starmie. No, it's a Seeking. Huh. Alright, and we can use... During its turn, we can place as many basic Pokémon we want on the bench if we have the place to place them. We can play as many trainer cards as we want, and we can evolve each Pokémon once, place one energy card per turn, and when we attack, the turn ends. Right, so let's heal Staryu. Let's attach an energy card and attack and end the turn. Just a low kick. Yeah, we're safe. And now we can evolve Staryu to Starmie. It already has enough energy to use Freeze. All evolved. Now let's finish this. Oh, and we have status effects like paralysis or sleeping or poisoned. I think... Yeah, that's it. The opponent is paralyzed. So until the beginning of our next turn, it can't attack. Unless the opponent uses a trainer card to fix this, like full heal. Yeah, there. He can't attack. Yeah, drew water energy. Doesn't matter. The game is over. There we go. Doesn't matter if he gets paralyzed. All done. And we won our first battle, even though the battle was staged for us to win it. And it was decided that we won. Basically, this is how the Pokémon trading card game is played. It's a game in which you try to knock out as many of your opponent's Pokémon as there are prizes. That's the gist of it. If you don't understand something, talk to Sam. It might be helpful to practice again too. This time was just practice, so I had you follow everything I said, but there are other styles of play. So try them out by choosing Normal Duel. Now then, let's build your deck. Did you bring your cards? We gave our cards to Dr. Mason and he never returned them. And now we can't play the game. That's it, game over. Let me add some of my own cards to yours. Now, Red, what kind of deck do you want? Right, we have the three starter Pokémon from the original game. I'm going to go with Squirtle. And 30 extra cards. You duel off with many different people. Why don't you go to one of the card clubs? Those are the gyms of this game. There are many people playing at the clubs. Collect new cards and try building a new deck. We will do that, yeah. So, let's check out our deck. Two Squirtles, one Wartortle, one Blastoise, Shield, Dugong, Goldeen. Yeah, it's a blue deck, it's a water deck. With some fighting things here and there, and some psychic things here and there. Also some colorless or any type or whatever they're called. Alright. Yeah, let's save here so we don't have to go through the tutorial again. Alright, let's now check if any of these guys want to battle. Alright, he explains how we can save, we already did that. Yeah, he would want to battle again. 8 clubs, yeah, just like the main Pokémon games. Yeah, we take booster packs when we defeat an opponent. And this guy talks about the legendary cards. And that we need to get the 8 medals before we go to the Pokémon Masters. Oh, and this guy tells us that when we get a Master Medal, we can go to the computer room in the back, right to the other side. And it will print us out the deck just like theirs. Hello? Any of you want to fight? Yeah, auto deck machine, blah blah blah. Alright, I will duel you. And he will give us an energy card booster pack. Yeah, let's duel you. Alright, we have basically a water deck, so let's fight against Lightning and Fire will be both good and bad. Yeah, let's go against the Grass and Psychic. 4 prize mats, alright. And Aaron doesn't have any basic Pokémon in his hand, so he will draw again. Alright, this is a Grass and Psychic deck, so let's begin with a Hitmonchan. And we will place Squirtle and Geodude on the bench. And we're ready to go. And we play first, that's great. Psychic energy. Yeah, we don't need it yet. Now let's attach a strength card to Hitmonchan and let's dab the Nidoran for 20 damage. Yeah. Oh, he's buffing up his drowsy on the bench. And we drew a seal. Yeah, let's place this on the bench. And here with the check option, we can see the cards on the field. Our cards, his card, his discard pile. We can't see his hand, obviously. And yeah, that's actually very helpful. And we can also see the abilities. All right. Right, let's attach another fighting energy to Hitmonchan so we can get the special punch, or yeah, special punch. And he evolves the drowsy to Hypno. Let me check that one out. And we drew a Rattata. Needs three cards to play Dark Mind. Oh, this attack does damage to our bench Pokémon without weakness or resistance. Yeah, okay. Right, let's place the Rattata. And let's attach the psychic energy to Hitmonchan so we can use the special punch. Alright, let's choose a prize. Yeah, let's choose the second one. A water energy. That will be great for Squirtle. And now he can use the Dark Mind, yeah. 60 damage due to weakness. Oh, I got the weaknesses and resistance in this row. That's bad for me. Right, let's use the water energy on Squirtle. And special punch is Hypno. Our Hitmonchan is going to be knocked out. And boom, he goes. Oh, he also damaged our Rattata with 10 damage. Yeah, that's okay. Squirtle, I choose you. And a Staryu, yeah, let's place that. A water energy on it. Actually, no, a water energy on Seal, yeah, that's... Seal has more health, so it's going to be more useful. And let's see if you're paralyzed. No, you ain't. I don't know if there are real consequences for losing a match, so here's what I'm going to do. Also, he uses build to throw two cards there, that's okay. I'm going to play each match. If I lose, then I'm going to cut out to the part of the match that I'm winning. But yeah, you will get to see at least my very first loss with each match. And yeah, he knocks out Rattata as well. And we've got a matchup. Yeah, let's place that. Let's attach a fighting energy to that. We must paralyze him. No, we didn't. So we can kiss Squirtle goodbye. Yeah, Squirtle goes out, and he will damage either. Are you? Okay. he is actually doing very good, or rather I'm doing very, very bad. Let's play Seal Out. We drew a Ghastly. Yeah, let's place that. Use the Psychic Energy, even though if one of my Pokémon dies right now, yeah, we're gonna lose the game. And he used Gust of Wind. It switches my active Pokémon with a benched one, so I'm guessing he's going to... Oh, Staryu. I thought you were going to use... Oh, we are screwed anyway. Right, we lost our first actual match. That's okay, I'm going to keep playing until I win this and you will get to see the play that I win. Also, let's find out if there are consequences for losing a match. Yeah, yeah, we lost. Boohoo. Yeah, I got a feel for my deck, but... Oh, no consequences. Alright, alright. Right, let's duel you again. This time, it's going to be the... What was it? Lightning and Fire deck. Yeah, let's play against that. Same basic story, we set up the game, and all that nice stuff, 4 prizes. We've only got a Rattata, that's not really good. And I have no other basic Pokémon to place on the bench. Yeah, just like with any other card game, there is a high randomness factor. What with the shuffling and all. We drew a water energy. Yeah, that's not very helpful right now. Double colorless energy to Charmander and Defender. This means that when we hit him next turn, it's reduced by 20 damage. So technically that makes my Rattata useless. And we drew Bill. Yeah, let's draw 2 cards. Water energy and psychic energy. No Pokémon, eh? Right, let's get rid of Defender. Yeah, he's building up his bench Pokémon. Professor Oak, we discard our hand and draw 7 cards. We drew an Abra, yeah. Finally we got a bench Pokémon, a basic Pokémon rather. Alright. And 20 damage to you. Now let's see what you have. Defender again. Okay. And a Meowth, yeah. I don't remember what does... Yeah, the Cat Punch. 20 damage to one of your opponent's Pokémon chosen at random. No weaknesses, no resistances. Okay. Let's build it up with a Water Energy card. And Bite to get rid of Defender. And you're going to bring out Charmeleon? No, Magnemite. Mm-hmm. 40 damage to our active Pokémon. It destroys itself and 10 damage to its benched Pokémon. To its benched Pokémon, even his. That was actually good. So we both get to take prizes. I drew Starmie. I don't even have a Staryu. Right. Abra is kind of flimsy right now. But he does paralyze the enemy. Yeah, let's go with Meowth. And it, yeah, it hit Growlithe, so let's see how this goes. So Growlithe is a dog and Meowth is a cat. Doesn't, you know, Growlithe have some advantage for Meowth? Don't get me wrong, I'm a cat person, but it's bigger. 20 damage. You are giving me crap. That's all I have to say. Let's heal up Meowth. And we hit Growlithe again. Yeah, it's closer to being knocked out. I get no Pokémon. Let's hope we hit the Growlithe again. No, we didn't. Oh, we knocked out his Voltorb. That's actually great. Let's use the last one. Psychic Energy. Fantastic. And we lose another Pokémon. Fantastic. I don't have many choices here. And we drew a seal at last. We can evolve to a Dugong, but next turn. We can't evolve the Pokémon on the same turn we play them. But Dugong needs a shitload of, of energy cards, so let's get to that. Doesn't matter if he doesn't get paralyzed, because it gets knocked out. And we drew a Lapras. That's actually pretty nice. Yeah, it has 80 hit points. That's good. And it will go up against a Charmander. Against which we get double damage. Abra goes down. No. So, let's stats. A water energy to Lapras, yeah. And attack with Psyshock. Let's hope we get him paralyzed. On the context of the game, I mean. We didn't. And now Abra goes down. Yeah, we get it. Alright, Lapras, it's your turn. More water energy, that's always good. If we have Pokémon on the bench. Let's use the Water Gun, and I think it goes down because Water Gun deals 10 plus 10 damage for each water card attached to Lapras, up to plus 20, but so now we actually deal 20 damage, but Charmander has weakness against water, so I'm guessing we deal 40 damage and he goes down. Yeah. And we won this match. Fantastic. Ho ho, you win! Here you go, as promised. We received the booster pack, Coliseum. It's just energy cards this time. Yeah, I got a feel for my deck. I also lost one time, but let's ignore that. Alright, anyone else want to fight here? We need a metal to activate the deck machines, the auto deck machines. Deck save. It does the obvious. Alright, nothing else here. Can we duel this guy again? Can we duel this guy again for, like, a reward or something? Normal duel, yes. Two prize duel using the practice deck? No, 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 screw that. Right, let's go out into the big world. So this is the world map, we have the clubs, somebody's house, the challenge hall, the Pokemon Dome, and yeah, the rest of the club. So the closest one to us is the fighting club, so let's go there. Oh, and this is Ronald. He got his first medal, yeah, he's a rival. Are you trying to get the legendary Pokemon cards? Yeah, yeah, yeah. What? I can't believe it. You? The legendary Pokemon cards? Ha 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 ha. Don't make me laugh. Alright, listen up. I'll teach you what it's about. To inherit the legendary Pokemon cards, you must defeat the 8 Club Masters and get the 8 medals. Then you have to go to Pokemon Dome and defeat all 4 of the Grand Masters there. There's no way you can do it. You might as well give up. And go home, because the legendary Pokemon cards are gonna be mine. I already won the first medal. Good for you. See ya, Red. Ha 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 ha. Alright, what a douchebag. Let's save. Alright, and this girl here explains us what the fighting club is all about. Here at this club, we duel using fighting Pokemon. No dirty dueling is allowed. Only nice, clean duels are allowed in this club. That wasn't much help. Oh, this is the lobby area, yeah. Granny, if I were just a few years younger, I'd be dueling with you kids too. Good for you. I see you play the Pokemon trading card game. I'm not into dueling. I prefer collecting the cards. By the way, would you happen to have Parasect? No, I do not. If you do, I was wondering if you might want to give it to me. How about it? I don't have a Parasect. Yeah, exactly. I appreciate your generosity, but you can't give me what you don't have. Come see me again after you get a Parasect. I was just saying which Grandmaster is the best. I think Steve is the best player. The best player among the Grandmasters is Rod, since he is the leader of the Grandmasters. Oh my god. Gift Center, yeah. This is a trading mode for the Game Boy. And I think this is for duels? Battle Center, yeah. No. Alright, let's go in the fighting area. I am Mitz, master of the fighting club. I have to warn you that you will be unable to defeat me. If you wish to duel with me, you must defeat my pupils first. My pupils are training at other clubs. Go see if you can defeat all three of my pupils. Alright, so the first club was Eruz. We have to find the first club members in other clubs. So we have the water deck. Yeah, maybe a good idea would be to go to the fire club already, I don't know, maybe? Greetings, welcome to the Fire Club. This is a club for boys with a burning passion for Fire Pokémon. Fire Pokémon have the greatest attack power of all Pokémon. Anyone want to duel? Energy cards are very important. Come back and see me when you collect a lot of energy cards. Then, I let you in on a secret. Oh, is this a fighting club member? I'm burning with Pokémon fever today. One day I'm going to inherit the legendary cards. No, it wasn't. Training so boring and out of date. Why do I have to do it? Why me? I'm Jessica of the fighting club. Oh, you must be Red. I heard about you from Mitz. Defeating you should be more fun than training. Alright, let's duel. Singing match for prizes. Right, let's see what we have here. Just a Lapras. Yeah, that doesn't sound very good. We have no bench Pokémon, so let's hope and pray everything goes well. Do we at least play first? No, we don't. Fury attack, flip the coins, does 10 damage the number of heads. Yeah. So up to 20, but also perhaps 0. 10 it is. We drew a Rattata. Yeah, let's play that. That we can also evolve to eradicate. But not yet. Let's use water energy on Lapras. And let's attack and end the turn. More fighting energy to Doduo. Does Doduo have another attack? 0 damage. That's actually really good. Alright, let's use the water energy on Lapras. Let's evolve Rattata to eradicate. And before we move on, let me check something. No, Doduo has just one attack, but yeah, she might want to retreat it. Alright. 90 damage for you. And you use Defender. Just 10 damage. And we drew a seal. Let's place that down. For now, let's use the psychic energy on Raticate. and end the turn without doing any damage because of Defender. Alright, he uses Monkey's Pick. It's a Pokemon power, those you can use no matter if the Pokemon is bent or if it's active. Once during your turn, before the attack, you may look at one of the following: a top card of either player's deck, random card from your opponent's hand, or one of either player's prizes. And it looked at the Starmie in my hand. Yeah, bad news for you. Ten more damage. And we drew a Seeking that we don't really need. Right, I'm not going to place any energy cards this turn. Let's see how this goes. Come on, give me something good. Professor Oak. That might actually be useful. But your Mangi has no energy. It's just going to waste. Don't waste a good Mangi. It just needed one card. Alright, I'm not going to complain. So let's put down Ghastly. Let's attach another Water Energy card to Lapras. And let me check out Haunter. Ooh, Haunter is good. Yeah, I'm not going to use Professor Oak now, I'm going to use next turn. For now, let's get rid of your Mankey. 30 damage, down you go. Let's pick our second prize. And the Blastoise that I can't yet play. If you don't do something now, you're going to lose next turn. You are going to lose next turn. You have no benched Pokemon, so I'm guessing... yeah, you're screwed. But just for the laughs of it, let's evolve Ghastly to a Haunter. And let's use Professor Oak. You don't have to show me all the animations, you know. I'm okay with that. Got a Geodude, Water Energy, Item Finder. Discard two cards from your hand and get a Trainer card from your discard pile to your hands. Yeah, that's good. Matchup and Energies. Right, let's finish this. And the Squirtle that we don't need because you have no more Pokemon to... yeah. And we got a booster pack. Let's see what we get with that. Dactrio, Seeking. I don't have... I have a Diglett. Yeah, there it goes. Nidorino, Raticate, a basic Pikachu, an Abra, Charmander, a Potion and a Fighting Energy. Not bad, not bad. We're going to use those in time. Oh, and the second booster pack. We get two each match? I love this. Fighting Energy Pinsir. What the hell is a Pinsir? Something that requires lots of energy cards. 20 damage and chance to paralyze. And just plain 50 damage. That's nice. Onitha, Seal, Magnemite, Diglett, Machop, Kadabra, Jigglypuff, and the Defender. How boring, I'm going home. Bye. Alright, you do that, you go home. And yeah, I think this is a good spot to end the first part. I'm going to actually play through all of this game and I hope you enjoy it as well. I will see you all next time. Until then, stay safe and have fun.